Our aim was to give as much music as possible for the money. So these arrangements are very complicated and a lot of things going on.
You always start with the drums, and then there's a track with percussion on it. A bass track. You're always mixing this order. And then there's guitar and another guitar. Pianos.
Dancing Queen was their biggest hit and a defining moment in the ABBA story. The world had been given its first unforgettable slice of Euro disco kitsch and a chorus that managed to rhyme Queen with 17 and tambourine.
The girls' voices are essential to the sound, of course, because they had these extremely compatible voices, because Agnetha was very punchy. And Frida had this hi-fi quality to it, because it was both very bright and very soft, bassy in itself. So they were very complementary to each other, these two voices.
Sometimes when they sang in unison, Agnetha perhaps going down a little and Frida struggling to get up to her, there was a certain sound to it. It was amazing.
A lot of hooks in that song. Like when you sing the verse and you go da 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 da, you know, every little thing is in the right place.